Hello and welcome. Today we make a USB Type-A female-to-female adapter with just a few parts. All we need is two USB Type-A female connectors, and these are the connectors. Pin 1 goes to pin 1 and pin 4 goes to pin 4. This is the main rule and it's very simple. You could use a cable if you wanted, but you don't really need to, so I will not use a cable. I will just connect them directly. Do this with this specific USB hack is where when we turn around the connector, we have to also spin it. So the main idea is that pin 1 goes to pin 1 so that we don't reverse the connectors. If we didn't do it like this, it would be reversed and it would be a bad idea. So it has to be like this. This is how it should look like. You could also move them a bit closer to each other. I'm not sure if this is really gonna work. I tried, it didn't really work for me. So this is, it looks nicer because the USB connector is more flat, but you can use a cable if that's really a problem. But I just chose to connect them as I showed you before. So just put a bit of solder on the connectors on both of them. Afterwards, you can put them together and make the joints stronger by just putting some fresh solder on each pin. You see, it's more shiny now and it looks like it's a better connection than before. Clean up the connector a little bit with some alcohol or what you have. And just now checking again, you see that's pin 1. And it goes to the other side again to pin 1. This is exactly what we need, so this should work. Make sure there are no shorts between the pins and the case, the metal case of the outside, and then just put some hot glue, cover the whole thing in hot glue. At this point it's ready, you could start using it or testing it, but I decided to make it a little bit nicer because this doesn't look very nice. Really doesn't, right? Yeah, it doesn't. It will look better in a short while, but first let's test it. I'm just gonna use a USB male cable and just plug in a flash drive and see if it works with another cable, the OTG cable. And yep, it's there. It works. I know this is a bit too much to do this, but it's just to test it. Yeah, it's all good, everything works. So now I'm just gonna put some heat shrink on the each side of the connector just to keep it more clean and make it look a bit better and not so sharp on those edges, the metal ones. So when you do this with the lighter, the hot glue also melts and you can use a flat surface, metal surface, to make it a bit nicer, to make the hot glue flat so it doesn't look like just a bunch of glue. It looks more like a case. The same on both sides, you do the heat shrink and it looks a bit better like that. You can also remove the excess hot glue from the connector if it's too much, but with the scissors I did it like this to flatten it and it works very well actually. You will not need this often, but when you do need it, it's gonna be a lifesaver. So keep it in your bag, in your backpack. It's very light and doesn't take much space. It's nice to have with you, together with the OTG cable. The alternative is just to buy it online. They're very cheap. You could easily buy this online, but when you need it now. And if you need it, this is a quick way to make it without any hassle. If you like this video, be sure to subscribe and click the bell to get notifications when we upload the new videos. There will be more videos like this, so subscribe for that. Tell your friends about this channel, share it on social media or whatever you can, and make sure that you like the video so we know that you like this one and we can make more like that. Subscribe, like and share, and I will see you next time. Bye.